Failover routing policies allow you to create active-passive setups in situations where you want a primary site in one location and a secondary data recovery site in another. So Revit 3 automatically monitors health checks from your primary site to determine the health of the endpoints. If an endpoint is determined to be in a failed state, all traffic is automatically directed to the secondary location. So for example, we have a primary and secondary web app backed by ALB, and Revit 3 determines our primary is unhealthy and fails over to the secondary ALB. I'm going to get my pen tool out here so we can have a closer look and notice that we are setting the failover routing policy. Notice that it has a set identifier just like our previous example. I'm calling this one primary and secondary, and we have to have different identifiers between our multiple resources so that we can use the same name and type. And then we are providing the records resources, resource records, but it's this failover routing policy that helps us determine based on the identifier where it's going to go. So there you go.